And we are back in Huron, getting ready for our second game of the day, the Lyman Raiders against the Wildcats of Kimball White Lake. I'm Steve Toome along with J.J. Hardigan. Great to have you here today on SDPB3. Our first team we'll look at here, the Wildcats of Kimball White Lake. Third year of this co-op, first time they've made it as a co-op. Kimball made it twice before into the state tournament. White Lake, they've never made it to the girls' basketball tournament. 15-7, their regular season record. They score 44 points a game. They shoot 33% from the floor, 61% from the free throw line. They beat Trip Delmont Armor and Corsica Stickney to win the district. And then they beat Burke South Central 53-33 to win Region 6B. Here's the starting lineup for Kimball White Lake.
Yeah, you see Ivy Haynes there, the 5'8 sophomore. She had a nice day yesterday against Sanborn Central Woonsocket. Haynes with 11 points, the only player in double figures in that game. Paige Munson, a 5'7 junior, can shoot the ball as well. And then the three guards, Mary Kropa, the 5'8 senior, Kelly Steffen, the 5'8 junior, and Jasmine Hinker, a 5'7 senior. Look for those three guards maybe to get a little bit more involved in the offense today. This is a team that scored just 27 points and shot 30% from the floor, Steve. They're a team that likes to get out and, as we mentioned, run the floor. Lyman the same, so this could be an up-and-down affair here today as we get ready to take a look at Lyman.
Hey, the Jasmine Hinker scores 14 points a game on the regular season. She had 9 yesterday, but really was bottled up. She's a 5'7 senior. But it's a balanced attack for the Wildcats. They have 7 points per game average from Kropa, from Haynes, 8 from Steffen, and 4 from Paige Munson. So, but Jasmine Hinker is really the player that makes things go for Kimball White Lake and the Wildcats. We'll take a break. Come back. We'll introduce you to the Lyman Raiders in just a couple of minutes. I'm Steve Toome along with J.J. Hardigan. This is the Class B Girls State Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
And welcome back to the Huron Civic Arena. Get ready for our second game of the day. The Wildcats of Kimball White Lake taking on the Lyman Raiders here on SDPB3. Steve Toome, J.J. Hardigan here. Let's look at the Lyman Raiders, a team that was last here in 1989. Head coach Cooper Garnas, who himself is a Lyman grad, getting the team back into the state tournament after a 15-8 campaign to get to the state tournament. Of course, the main school located in Presho. They used to be called Lyman County back in the day. They shortened it to just Lyman. They average 46 points a game. They shoot just about 34% from the floor, 66% from the free throw line. They beat Kadoka 65-38 in the districts, then White River 64-46. They had to play 3 games to get out of their district. Beat Jones County for the title 46-43, and then beat New Underwood in a game played at Wall 48-44 to win Region 7B. Let's look at the starting lineup for the Lyman Raiders.
You see Bailey Allman there, the 5'7 senior who can play both the guard and forward position, along with Anna Flintner, the 5'8 senior, Haley Halverson, a 5'10 senior, Chesney Garnas, the daughter of the head coach, 5'5 senior on this squad, and Brooklyn Halverson, who can also play both the forward and the center position there, a 5'11 freshman who can get in there. And really, it's unfortunate for Lyman. They ran into a buzzsaw last night in Hanson, who scored the most points out of all of the teams in this tournament yesterday. They had 69 total points in that game, did Hanson. And Lyman, of course, finished with just 36 points, 35% shooting. They were 33% from three-point land. Again, just one player in double figures. That was Brooklyn Halverson, who had 14 points, 4 rebounds on the day of 6 of 15 shooting. Look for Chesney Garnas maybe to get a little bit more involved in the offense today. She got hot there towards the end of the game with 7 points, was 3 of 6 from the floor. She's got a picture-perfect shot, and when she can get those open looks, she's deadly from long distance.
On the season, no Raider averaged double figures, but they kind of came at you in waves. Garnas and Allman averaged 8.5 points a game, 7.5 for Flintner, just over 7 for Brooklyn Halverson. Sister Haley Halverson averaged 4.5 points a game. Cedar Jandrew, who had a big game at the regions, came up empty yesterday. No points. She averages 5.5 points and 3.5 rebounds per game, but she was shut down yesterday as Lyman fell to the Hanson Beaverettes in first-round action. So the Raiders looking to turn it around today. They will take on Kimball White Lake. We'll take a break, come back, and have our second basketball of the game, or second basketball game of the day here on SDPB 3. This is the Class B girls basketball tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Welcome back inside the Huron Arena. As you get a look there, Kimball White Lake, the sixth seed in our tournament, getting set to take on the number seven seed Lyman Raiders. Lyman will be in the home whites today with red lettering and black and red trim. Kimball White Lake will wear their black uniforms with green lettering here today as we get underway. And you look on the screen, you get a look at the Lyman Raiders finishing up some warm-up shots just about a minute or so away from this game. Steve, what are we expecting in this matchup here today?
Close game. These two teams played late in the regular season, and it was Kimball White Lake posting a 43-38 victory. I expect the same here today. These two schools know each other very well, pretty close to each other. Again, 43-38 was that score. Kimball White Lake beating the Raiders. These teams match up pretty evenly height-wise. And again, no super scorer for either team. They rely on a balanced attack. Jasmine Hinker, the top scorer for the Wildcats, and Garnas and Allman leading the way for the Raiders. Got an update halftime from the A tournament. Pine Ridge and Garrison tied up at 18 apiece. Should be a good one here today.
Both teams are ready to go, and so are we. We need to turn it over now to our public address announcer, Josh Hader, as he gets into starting lineups for tonight's game between, or actually this afternoon's game rather, between Kimball White Lake and Lyman here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. And this is SDPB 3. Here's your PA announcer, Josh Hader.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Huron Arena for the second game between the Lyman Raiders and the Kimball White Lake Wildcats. Let's meet the starters for today's game. At guard for the Raiders, number 12, Brooklyn Helverson. At guard for the Wildcats, number 10, Mary Kropa. At forward for the Raiders, number 14, Anna Flitner. At forward for the Wildcats, number 11, Ivy Haynes. At guard for the Raiders, number 22, Chesney Garnas. At guard for the Wildcats, number 15, Jasmine Hinker. At guard for the Raiders, number 24, Bailey Almond. At forward for the Wildcats, number 20, Paige Munson. At center for the Raiders, number 30, Haley Helverson. And at guard for the Wildcats, number 24, Kelly Steffen. The Raiders are coached by Brittany Ruman and Cooper Garnas. The Wildcats are coached by Preston Christensen, Tia DeGeest, and Tacey Nielsen. The officials for today's game are Scott Hookie, Bill Shanefish, Matt Clark, and Brett Sether.
We are set for our second game of the afternoon. After this one, we reach the halfway point of our tournament. But first, we got to bring you Kimball White Lake number 6, Lyman number 7 here at the Class B Girls State Basketball Tournament in Huron, South Dakota. Lyman again will wear the white uniforms. You see the Wildcats there with the capital L and the capital K. In the black uniforms with green lettering and white trim, some blue down the sides of their jerseys as well. And I'm J.J. Hardigan, Steve Toome joining me courtside here today for this matchup between these two Class B teams. The winner will play Lemon in our fifth place consolation championship game tomorrow at 1:45. Whoever ends up on the losing end of this will play Gayville Vollen tomorrow at noon in our seventh and eighth place game. Tip will go to the Wildcats as we get things underway here tonight. They will work from right to left from your screen back home or wherever you are across the country or online on sdpb.org. First points of the day go to the Wildcats. And that's going to be Ivy Haynes, who kicks things off just like she did yesterday with a big bucket here for Kimball White Lake.
Right away, the Wildcats go inside. They posted up Haynes. She got a good angle to score that bucket. Nice job of establishing position in the post.
Ball to top of the key. Lyman working the ball around the perimeter. Get it into the right wing. Setting up shot, Anna Flintner. She dribbles to the baseline, picks up her dribble again, kicks it outside. Again, Lyman is a very patient team offensively. Garnis gets it back into the right wing. She's going to try the long three. We talked, she can shoot it from long distance. Had a pretty good look there, couldn't fall. They go back on defense, down 2-0. Wildcats with the ball in the early lead here.
Lyman going man-to-man defensively. Both teams played a lot of zone yesterday. Expect a little more man-to-man today.
Long two from the right wing, no good. Rebounded by Lyman. Bringing that one out. Halverson. Now Garnis will push it across the half-court line. She gets it into the left wing. Flintner caught underneath the hoop, takes it back outside. The long two for Halverson is good.
Haley Halverson left wide open at the free throw line.
Halverson averaging 4.5 points a game, 3.5 rebounds. More of a defensive player down there for Lyman. Wildcats with the ball. They'll get their offense set up. Dribbling inside, now picking up the ball is Hinker. She'll kick it back outside to the top of the key to Haynes.
Yeah, both these teams looked at man-to-man defenses yesterday while playing zone most of the time.
Kropa bounces it inside. Some congestion inside the lane. That one's going to go off, I believe, Lyman's foot. One of the players in there. They had three white jerseys in the mix. Either way, it'll be Wildcat ball with even 6 minutes left to go here in this second quarter. Quick inbound to the left block. Shot no good, but a foul. And Ivy Haynes, who got the first points of the day for Kimball Whitelake, will go to the free throw line now for two.
And that foul will be on Brooklyn Halverson. The freshman got her first.
First attempt of the day from the free throw line. Hits the front of the iron. No good.
Haynes 64% on the season from the charity stripe.
Second attempt on the way is good. 1-2 this trip around. Back to a one-point lead for Lyman, and back and forth we go here in the early goings. Already the second lead change of the day. Had one tie, 3-2 your score, 5:48 your score. Lyman with the ball inside the right wing. Now up to the top of the key. Halverson swings it into the left wing to Garnis. Back to the top of the key, driving inside, little floater, no good. Missed everything that time from Allman, but the putback is good from the right block. That's Brooklyn Halverson, who had 14 points, 4 rebounds in 28 minutes last night. 4-3 your score now. Turnover as Lyman gets it. Garnis picked up her dribble early, needs some help in the backcourt, but gets it across the half-court line. Allman into the left wing, ball dropped by the big post player underneath there. That was Haley Halverson. And the white leg with the ball now. 5:03 left to go in the first quarter, and a foul near the left baseline. They're going to call that one on Anna Flintner. That'll be her first. And the inbound coming from the baseline now is Kropa inbounds it into the backcourt. Nobody touched it, though, and so it. They're able to run it down, and Kelly Steffen can get things going now with under 5 minutes to play in this first quarter. 4-3 your score in the early goings here in Huron. Steffen inside the paint, kicks it outside. Three from the right wing, in and out, no good. Rebound by Kropa, she'll bring it back out. 4:43 left to go now in this first quarter.
Weak side rebound, you have to box out.
Hinker gets it into the left wing. Now back to the top of the key. Kropa for three. That one off the left side of the iron. No good. Ball's loose on the floor. Diving after it. And they're going to say, I believe, a jump ball. Nice hustle that time by Lyman's Anna Flintner to get to it as we get to our first media timeout of the day. 4:26 left to go in the first quarter. 4-3 your score. Back with more from the Huron Arena after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Back in Huron here with 4:26 left to go. Lyman with the 4-3 lead over Kimball Whitelake. They've got the ball out of the media timeout. Some full court pressure coming from the Wildcats. Lyman's Garnis gets across the half-court line just in front of our spot here at the scorer's table. Crosses over to the left hand into the left wing. Thought about the three, but instead, they'll kick it around the perimeter. Three on the way from the right wing off the front of the iron. No good. Offensive rebound for Lyman. The putback no good off the iron. Nice effort that time from Brooklyn Halverson. Just couldn't quite finish it off. Now under 4 minutes left to go, and the Wildcats with a chance to take the lead.
Wildcats were playing 2-3 zone once again. Lyman again going back to man-to-man.
Haynes with the bounce pass to Hinker at the free throw line. Back outside, Steffen for three. That one's good. And that gives the Wildcats a two-point lead. It's 6-4. 3:38 left to go in this first quarter of action. Back and forth we go.
Steffen had just 2 points yesterday. She's already surpassed that total.
Ball into the right wing. Garnes thought about the three, dribbles inside. Tough shot, bad angle, but she gets it to go. Garnes, again, we've said, has a great shooter's touch, has a great feel for the game, obviously with her dad being the head coach of the team here now in her senior year. One of the more vocal leaders on the floor as well for Lyman. Three on the way from the top of the key, no good. Kropa with the miss. Rebound underneath for the Wildcats. The putback no good there. And here we go again with Lyman pushing it in transition. I think Munson thought she might have gotten fouled on the other end there. Either way, Lyman with the ball. In a 6-6 game here as Kropa tries to post up on the post player underneath, and a foul called on the play. That's actually going to be Halverson who goes to the line. Haley Halverson, just 2 points in the game last night.
A foul is going to be on Paige Munson. That'll be her first.
Had only one free throw attempt last night, missed it. This one here off the right side of the iron. Both teams doing some subbing now. Kimball White Lake will bring in Brooklyn Donald. And for Lyman, checking in for the first time today, it'll be Cedar Jandrew. Free throw hits the iron, hits the backboard, rolls around once and goes through here with 2:47 left to go, 7-6. Lyman with a 1 point edge. Kimball White Lake with the ball though as they get it into the right wing. Pass up to the top of the key, nearly taken away. Kropa gets it to Steffen in the left wing. Back to Kropa in the left corner, though. She'll bring it out with the right-handed dribble here with 2:22 left to go in the first quarter. Now Kropa making a move right side of the paint. Kicks it back out around the perimeter. Steffen at the top of the key. Passes left side of the paint. Driving inside is Hinker. A foul, and she'll go to the line for two.
Nice drive by Hinker. Had the angle of the bucket. Defender had to come over, commit the foul. That's going to be on Flitner, and that's her second.
Taking a look at Hinker's numbers yesterday from the free throw line. She went 2-for-4 from the stripe with 9 points overall. Makes her first here. More subbing going on for Lyman. Flitner will take a seat on the bench, and checking back in, Bailey Allman.
65% is Hinker from the free throw line this year.
Second attempt is good. She goes 2-for-2, and Kimball White Lake retakes the 8-7 lead. Kind of going according to plan here so far. Both teams going back and forth, just trying to feel each other out, find a way to maybe get a little advantage as Garnes tries the three from the left wing, no good. And a foul called underneath. They're going to call this one, I believe, on Kimball White Lake. No, they're going to say it went off her foot, I believe, instead.
Yep. Going to stay with Lyman in the front court.
2:01 left to go now here in the first quarter. Allman with the inbound, gets it into the right corner. Pass tipped away but recovered by Garnes at the top of the key. Back inside, and now a foul. Two free throws coming up. That will send Lyman's Bailey Allman to the free throw line. They're going to get Brooklyn Donald for the foul.
Second team foul. Good recognition by Lyman to swing the ball over to the left side and find the open player in Allman.
Right-handed release on the way is good.
Allman 53% on the season from the free throw line.
1-0-2 last night. Her first two looks at the stripe here today. First one was good. Second attempt, good as well. And Lyman are taking the lead now. 9-8 in her score, under 2 minutes left to go. Steffen into the left wing, setting up the offense for the Wildcats. Looking to her right now, crosses over, goes to her left with the open shooter in the corner, but they want to try to get the ball inside. Kropa nearly had it taken away. They're going to get Garnes for the reach in there.
That's going to be her first foul. She almost had the steal there. Wildcats, you're lucky that wasn't a turnover.
Kropa inbounding it in front of the Lyman bench. Looks to the right, now gets it to Steffen near the half court line. She'll bring it up towards the top of the key into the right corner. Donald, down bounces it inside, but it rolls away from everybody. It'll go out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by the Wildcats. So Lyman ball here with a minute 30 left to go. Wildcats doing some more subbing as Munson checks back into the game. 9-8 in the score.
Brooklyn Donald to the bench for the Wildcats. Kind of amazing that last pass went through all those players and ended up out of bounds with nobody touching it.
Ball in the left wing as they set up shop offensively. They get it to Garnes at the top of the key, swinging it around to the right side. Three on the way off the backside of the iron, and an offensive foul called on Lyman. They're going to get Haley Halverson for the foul. Trying to go over the back that time. Right on top of it. Wildcats with the ball now down by one.
A sub in here for the Raiders. They're going to get Ashley Mortensen into the game. Five team fouls already on the Raiders.
Full court pressure coming from Lyman. Following Stephen into the front court. It'll be Allman. He's crossing the half court line now. Stephen tried to pass it into the right wing. Miscommunication though. Munson cut inside instead of going back out. Allman for the layup, no good. Munson fighting for the rebound inside for Kimball White Lake, and she might have just gotten called for the foul. We'll see for sure who this one's on. And no, it won't be on Munson. Instead, they're going to give it to Kelly Stephan, who came in late and tried to swat that shot away. Free throws coming up now for Jandrew. And release is good.
It's her first point of the tournament.
Lyman taking a two-point edge here. Second attempt on the way. And that one goes in and out, no good. Rebound by Kimball White Lake. That was Ivy Haynes who came down with the rebound. Munson at the top of the key, setting up the offense. Now into the left wing to Stephan. Under a minute left to go in the first quarter. Three from the left corner on the way, rolls in. Shooter's touch that time on the other end for Kropa. 35 seconds left to go. You got to figure Lyman's going to be trying for the last shot here. Down by one. Their head coach trying to get everybody in position.
Yep. Cooper Garneau's yelling out one. Waiting for that last shot.
Ball in the left wing. Garneau's thought about the three. Instead drives inside. Got tangled up by one of the defenders. Ball loose on the floor. And it looks like there might be a jump ball. As both Munson and Garneau got tangled up underneath the Lyman hoop.
Yep, and the possession arrow favors Kimball White Lake. Coach Garneau is not happy. He wanted his team to play them for the final shot. Instead, it's going to be the Wildcats with the opportunity, provided they get the ball inbounds.
14 seconds left to go. Wildcats with the ball and the lead. It's the one-point advantage here right now. The ball into Kropa's hands in the right wing. Back to the free throw line. Hinker finds Stephan, top of the key for three. Nope, off the left side of the iron. And that's how your first quarter comes to an end. Kimball White Lake ends up taking a lead out of the first quarter in what has been a very back-and-forth affair, 11-10. Back with more in the second quarter from the Huron Arena and the Class B Girls State Basketball Tournament here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Back in the Huron Arena, as you see the score out of the first quarter, Kimball White Lake, the Wildcats, leading the Lyman Raiders 11-10. Lyman with the ball to start the second quarter. Garnes, top of the key, will get bounce pass into the left wing. Lyman trying to get the offense rolling here. Both teams know each other well, obviously, after playing during the regular season. And a nice shot inside the lane that time from Halverson. It's a one-point edge now for the Raiders. Shot no good. Rebounded underneath and a jump ball. Munson has been around the hoop basically every time a shot's been put up today. That's about the second or third time, Steve, she's been involved in a jump ball already today. Luckily, this time it favors her team, the Wildcats. She gets inbounded into the backcourt. Chasing after it is Hines. Nobody touched it on the inbound, so they can throw it into the backcourt without the over and back. Now as Hinker brings it up to the free throw line. She gets inside the paint, shot off the glass is good. It kind of froze there for a second on the back of the iron, but gets that shooter's roll back through the nylon.
I thought Vermoe was going to stay up there and have a dead ball with it on the back paddles. We got a steal by Kimball Whitelight.
Stepping with the steal inside the lane, just in the right place at the right time there. Brings it into the front court with 7:05 left to go in the second quarter. Hinker in at the top of the key. Sends it into the right wing. On pass inside, Ivy Haynes with the reception and the putback. Nice pass that time from Kropa as she gets credited with the assist.
You can see that both teams are much more comfortable in this matchup going inside. That was not the case for both teams yesterday, as they were giving up a lot of height in the first day.
3-point lead, and now a bad pass stolen away, and Garnas is going to pick up the foul. A little hip check near the top of the key. That'll be her second here with 6:37 left to go. And Kimball White Lake with their largest lead of the day right now at 3. They're looking for more. Timeout on the floor by Lyman with 6:37 left to go. 15-12 your score. You take a look at the Kimball White Lake bench. They go into the huddle and want to talk things over and how they want to handle this offensive set.
Don't forget, you can purchase a DVD copy of any of the tournaments from the girls' championships by calling 1-800-456-0766. DVD copies are $19.95 plus $5 for shipping and handling. Now, if you're a member of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, the shipping is free. Call 1-800-456-0766, or you can log on to sdpb.org. Click on the shopping cart for your copy of any of the state girls basketball tournaments.
Great views from around the arena here today. Obviously a great crowd from our first game today. Crowds have stuck around really throughout much of this, and obviously that really is a testament to what the B tournament's all about. It seems like these small communities come out, and even if it's not their team playing, they're supporting whoever's on the floor. It's such an honor for these schools to get here just to be at the state tournament, but I think that they're willing to come and get their money's worth and watch as much basketball as they can.
Yeah, it's the last basketball of the year, so you might as well get every penny's worth, and some good action so far here today at the Class B.
3-point lead right now for the Wildcats. Onto the right wing, Steffen finds Hinker. Hinker with a left-handed dribble. Back to Steffen, 3 from the top of the key, off the backside of the iron, no good. Lyman with the rebound. It'll be Almond to get it into the front court, kicks it into the right wing. Garnos is wide open, steps inside, short 2, a little soft on the release. Ball's kept alive by Jandrew, but it'll end up in the hands of the Wildcats as Hinker pushes it into transition. Top of the key, Steffen again wide open, fakes the 3, dribbles inside the paint. And a little underhanded pass, probably not to the spot they wanted there with Munson double team. Jandrew now in the left wing, finds Almond left wing for 3. That one's soft and a little flat. Missed off the left side of the iron as that ball goes out of bounds. Lee Kimball White Lake ball now with 5:38 left to go. Some more subbing going on as Brooklyn Donald checks in. Munson will take a seat on the bench. 15-12 your score. Quick check here, Lyman with 16 fouls, Kimball White Lake with 3. Lyman commits a foul here, it'll be a 1-1 situation for the Wildcats.
2-1-2 zone now for the Raiders. They have been man-to-man most of the game. Switching things up now.
Open the left corner up to the top to Key Hinker. Back to Steffen in the right wing. But again in the right corner now. The left-handed dribble gets it up to the top of the key. They're looking inside. The great defense by Lyman preventing that interior pass here with 5:08 left to go. Propa left corner. On about the 3 again. Still thinking about it. Now dribbles. Back to Propa. Now she'll try the 3 and it's off the back of the iron. No good. But an offensive rebound for Ivy Haynes. Propa in the left wing again. Cross-court pass finds Hinker right side of the paint. That jumper is good. Nice court recognition that time from Kropa. She didn't take the shot right away. She was looking to pass first, took the shot when she was wide open, and on that second opportunity, found the open shooter Hinker with a more high percentage shot and was able to finish it off.
Yeah, you have to have good movement away from the basketball and crisp passing in order to beat a zone defense.
Lyman finding themselves down by 5 now, trying to get back into it. Got an open shooter in the right wing. Back inside, Jandrew with the quick 2. That one's good from the left post. Again, very unselfish basketball from both teams. 3-point game as Steffen has the ball tipped out of her hands. Jandrew, or Garnas, I should say, comes away with it, but the ball taken right back by Kropa. Her right-handed layup no good, and she'll go to the free throw line for 2. Both teams getting a little chippy on the defensive end.
Yeah, things getting a little helter-skelter here as Brooklyn Halverson picks up her second personal foul. Kropa at the line, 65% on the year.
Free throw attempt hits the right side of the iron, but misses badly. Second attempt coming up here in just a moment. Next time out, we'll get you a look around the rest of the state and what's going on in games elsewhere with state tournament basketball going on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Girls state basketball this weekend, boys will be next weekend. Lob pass inside from Garnas, but they're going to bring it back out. Lines to the top of Keita Allman, swings it around into the left wing, driving inside and trying for the right-handed layup, but no good on the play was Flitner. Still fighting for the ball, Garnas bounced off, I believe.
It's going
to
stay.
That was Ivy Haynes that who went to the floor, and it's going to stay Lyman ball. Timeout on the floor with 3:41 left to go. We'll take a timeout as well. This is the Class B Girls State Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Back inside the Huron Arena, 3:41 left to go. Lyman with the ball underneath their own hoop here. Willie Allman to inbound it from the baseline, getting it to Garnas at the top of the key. Garnas swings it into the right wing. She wants it back. A couple quick dribbles, now picks it up. Flitner finds Allman left wing. She drives inside. Contact as she goes in hard for the layup. Foul on the play called on Kimball White Lake. That'll be their fourth team foul. And it'll send Allman to the free throw line here for two.
Ivy Haynes going to get tagged for that personal foul. That is her first.
Free throw attempt is good from Allman.
On the air, 53%.
Two for two this time around, and Lyman back within one. 3:26 left to go. The Hinker at the top of the key, crossing over on Garnas, driving inside for the right-handed layup. Nifty ball handling move there to get past the defender. She left everybody in her dust that time, and back to a three-point lead now for Kimball White Lake. And a turnover for Lyman as the ball goes out of bounds near the Wildcat bench. Brooklyn Donald will take a seat on the bench and a timeout called by Lyman. 3:11 left to go, 19-16 your score here in the Huron Civic Arena. Take a look at Cooper Garnas and the Lyman Raiders.
Don't forget our coverage starts at 6 Central, 5 Mountain tonight. Semifinals here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting, SDPB3. Tonight it'll be Sully Buttes taking on Warner, and then it's Hanson versus Sanborn Central Woonsocket. Should be some terrific semifinals here tonight on SDPB3 television and online at sdpb.org.
3:11 left to go. It's a three-point game right now in this Class B tournament action. Both teams lost last night, hoping for their first wins of the tournament here today. Winner of this game will play Lemon in our consolation championship game tomorrow at 1:45 right here on SDPB3. Steppen from the left wing, drove inside, a little too strong off the glass. Ball loose on the floor, picked up by Garnas. Into the front court we go. Garnas at the top of the key with two defenders in front of her, picks up her dribble, kicks it inside. Allman now with the ball on the right wing. Back to Garnas. Allman wide open all by herself in the right wing right now. But instead, it'll be Flitner driving baseline, now picking up her dribble. Garnas back to Allman in the right wing. Defense collapses. Garnas open. She'll try a three. That one off the right side of the iron. No good. Stepping with the rebound. 19-16 your score. Wildcats trying to add to their lead here. And a foul inside as Munson tried for the little right-handed putback from about 3 feet away. She'll go to the line for two. As Lyman's Bailey Allman gets called for the foul, her first. Munson.
18 fouls so far on the Raiders.
Trying a first free throw attempt. That one in and out, no good.
44% on the year for the 5'7 junior. Averages 4 points, 4 rebounds per game.
19-16 your score. We've gone back and forth here, although Kimball White Lake had a lead by as many as 5 in this one. They've got a 4-point edge now, 20-16 with 2:20 left to go. Bailey Allman into the front court, fakes a pass to the right, instead goes to Garnas in the left wing. Cross court pass to Chandru. She drives baseline and a foul on the play. Both players were pushing. They're going to get Kropa for the foul. So that will be Kimber Whitelake's 15th foul. Kropa's first as Chandru checks out for Lyman. Wildcats still have one foul to give here in the first half. They've done a nice job defensively on Lyman overall here so far today. Allman passes it inside. Turnaround from the left block, no good off the fingertips of Halverson. Rebounded by the Wildcats, and Henker will push it into the front court. Minute 55 left to go. Kropa into the right corner, bounce pass now to the free throw line. Henker gets it to Munson momentarily. Now to Stephan as she fakes the three. Got Allman in the air. Her shot blocked from behind, though. Into the front court. Garnis trying to hold on to the ball, but they're going to get her for the travel.
And that pass was thrown into a crowd, and Garnis tried to collect it, just couldn't stop her momentum. As several players had a chance at that basketball, but the turnover gives it to the Wildcats. Update from the A, Pine Ridge leading Gerritsen in the fourth early on, 30-25.
Ball into the right wing. Stephan. Getting it to Kropa for a moment. Now Tinker at the top of the key with a minute 24 left to go. She goes left side of the paint, jumper off the front of the iron, no good. Rebounded by Bailey Allman. Allman will bring it up. Probably a little too much time for Lyman to try to fight for the last shot here, and down by four. You'd like to see them get a quick bucket, maybe get a steal on the other end, as we talked about earlier today. With this time and without a shot clock, it's ideal to try to get that quick bucket and get back defensively and see if you can't tie up the game. Allman fakes the three at the top of the key, now at the free throw line, her jumper no good. And instead, it'll be Ivy Haynes to bring it up. Under a minute left to go, and now the Wildcats with that four-point lead, Steve, have the luxury of really slowing this thing down.
Yep, and Tinker calls out a play. Let's see if she'll take it. She will.
Left-handed layup is good. 22-16, your score. Lyman trying for the last shot here.
I thought the Wildcats were going to play for the last shot when Hinker brought it out, but it just opened up the lane for her, and she managed to make a nifty left-handed layup. She's got 10 points in the game.
Six-point lead for the Wildcats, their largest lead of the day. Lyman running the clock down to 10 seconds here now. 22-16, Kimball White Lake. Cooper Garnis calling out the signals. Allman's pass was tipped, recovered by Munson. Now Stephan at the half-court line throws one up, but she runs out of time and runs out of space as the first half comes to an end. Kimball White Lake, the Wildcats, taking a 22-16 lead over the Lyman Raiders into the locker room at halftime. We'll take a timeout. Steve and I will be back in just a moment with a full recap of this first half of action on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
Back inside the Huron Arena at halftime, Kimball White Lake, the Wildcats leading the Lyman Raiders 22-16. Kimball, who shot just 27% in their first game against Sanborn Central Woonsocket in the first half. A much better first half here today, Steve. They go 8 of 19, good for 42%. Jasmine Hinker already in double figures with 10 points on 4 of 7 shooting. She's played 15 minutes. In fact, Kimball White Lake has only brought in one reserve so far today. They've really stuck with their starting five, and it's paid off for them so far, playing much better here so far today against the Lyman Raiders.
Yeah, they've been able to move the ball inside, have the Wildcats, and certainly that's something they wanted to do. They just could not do it yesterday in their first-round matchup. Checking out the individual scoring first for Kimball White Lake. Jasmine Hinker leading the way with 10 points, 5 for Ivy Haynes, 3 each for Mary Kropa and for Kelly Stephan, and 1 point for Paige Munson. Brooklyn Donald has come in, played almost 4 minutes, has yet to get into the scoring column. 2 of 9 from 3-point land for the Wildcats, and they are 4 of 8 at the free throw line. Meanwhile, for Lyman, they are being led with a couple of players with 4 points. We mentioned their balanced attack, and that's what they've got so far. Bailey Allman and Brooklyn Halverson each with 4. 3 apiece for Haley Halverson and Cedar Jandrew. 2 points for Chesney Garnos. Anna Flittner yet to score in this particular contest. Ashley Mortensen came in for a little over a minute, did not score. Rebounding 14-12, the advantage for Kimball White Lake. The Raiders are 5 of 20 from the floor, 0 of 6 from beyond the arc, and 6 of 8 at the free throw line. I think the key was that second period. And once again, we've seen that second period really be the bellwether period in a lot of our games so far. Kimball White Lake outscored Lyman 11-6 in that second period of play.
And if you look at the numbers for Kimball White Lake overall, a very balanced attack today. Not only from their players individually, but as a team, they scored 11 points in the first quarter, 11 in the second. They know what they want to do there, and they're trying to really work the ball inside. But when they've had those open jumpers, they've been willing to take it. But really, it's been the smarts of their players, like Ivy Haynes, Mary Cropin, some of those players standing around the perimeter. They're faking shots, getting defenders in the air. If Lyman can just stay within themselves, settle down a little bit, not get their feet off the ground so quickly, they might be able to make a few more stops and get back in this. It's only a six-point game right now at halftime, but even so, Lyman needs to get their shooting going. 5 of 20 in the first half at 25%. They were 0 of 6 from three-point land. As you take a look at the band who's been entertaining the crowd all day today, that's that Northern band, Northwestern, who's coming up here today and putting on a great show so far here in the Huron Arena.
Talk about a great show. We got one going over at the AA tournament. They're in the second quarter, about halfway through, and they've got a shootout going. Roosevelt leading Rapid City Stevens 36-22. That one's going to have some points scored in it in that AA consolation bracket game earlier today at the AA. It was Spearfish defeating Harrisburg 48-45. Get you an update from the A tournament. They're just getting under, or they're in the fourth quarter of their first game out west, and that is Pine Ridge leading Garrettson 28-23. That is early in the fourth period of play. Here at the B tournament earlier today, it was Lemon defeating Gayville Vollen 55-41. So Lemon awaits the winner of this particular contest. And don't forget, our action begins at 6 o'clock tonight, 6 Central, 5 Mountain Time. We'll have that semifinal matchup, Sully Buttes versus Warner, followed by Hanson versus South Central, or South Sanborn Central, Woonsocket.
Right now, it's a 22-16 Kimball White Lake lead over Lyman. We are going to step aside. When we come back, we'll get you the second half of action. It's our second game of the day from the Class B tournament here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Back inside the Huron Arena, we are moments away from the start of this second half. Obviously, it was an exciting first half of action here, Steve. We're expecting much the same as we get this second half underway. Kimball White Lake taking a 22-16 lead into this third quarter here. Kimball White Lake has scored 11 points in each of the first two quarters. Lyman had 10 double figures in the first quarter, but were held to just 6 there in that second quarter. And Lyman 5 of 20 overall from the floor today. Look for their offense maybe to get rolling here in the second half.
The Wildcats started off man-to-man. They switched up to that 2-3 zone defense, and I think that took the Raiders, knocked them a little off balance there, a little trouble adjusting to that as the Wildcats were able to force some turnovers. Let's see how the Raiders respond here. They will start the third period with the basketball.
8 minutes put on the clock here, 22-16 your score. It will be Lyman with the ball to kick things off. Almond will inbound it near the half-court line, and Garnis will bring it up. Taking a look at some of the individual numbers right now. Hinker the only one in double figures for either team here so far today. Wildcats playing defense at the moment though. Jumper from the right post, no good. Rebounded by Paige Munson.
Munson does a good job of boxing out.
7:40 left to go, 22-16. Kimball White Lake with the lead, trying to extend it. Stephen gets the ball in the left wing. Kicks it up to the top of Kita Kropa. Long two, no good. Missed the iron completely, hit the backboard that time. 7:25 left to go in the third quarter. Almond brings it up across the half court line. Halverson with the ball. Momentarily now kicks it into the right wing to Brooklyn Halverson. Garnis thought about the three, couldn't pull the trigger though. Looks inside at the pass, instead goes to the right to Almond. Almond, right wing, steps inside the arc. Down low, Halverson with a right-handed turnaround, no good. Too strong off the iron. Excuse me, to the other end we go. Pinker. Find Stephen right wing. She goes up to the free throw line now into the left wing. Kropa inside the paint. Bounce pass to the right post and a foul. Ivy Haynes heads back to the charity strike. Good court recognition again there. And Ivy Haynes 9 points, four rebounds so far on the day. It's a perfect 2 for 2 from the floor. 1 of 2 from the free throw line so far today.
Haley Halverson picking up the foul. That's her second. Nice job by Haynes just to hang out there along the baseline and a good pass to set her up.
23-16 here at the moment as the second attempt is on the front of the iron. No good. Allman with the rebound for Lyman. She'll bring it into the front court. Anchor guarding her at the top of the key. Halverson finds the shooter in the left wing. Stepping inside, long two, misses everything. Garnes with the rebound, though. Her putback off the rim, no good. Ball recovered by Lyman, and a foul is going to be called on Kimball White Lake.
Better job by Lyman crashing the offensive glass here in the early third quarter.
Going to call that on Kimball White Lake's Kelly Steffen. Picks up her second personal foul, first team foul in the half here for the Wildcats. Ball into the left corner. Allman for three. That hits the glass. Bounces off the iron. No good. But now
Haynes couldn't gather the rebound. Yeah.
Haynes was trying to keep it alive before it went out of bounds. But she stepped on the baseline. So it'll stay Lyman ball. They're down 23-16. Looking for their first points in this second half. Garnes in the left corner. Dribbles away. Now gets it up in the top of the key to Allman. Allman back to Garnes in the left wing. She dribbles up. Lobs it inside. Back to Garnes at the free throw line. Her jumper off the right side of the iron, no good. Halverson's put back, no good. And it'll be Kropa who comes away with it for the Wildcats. She's going to push it. And the White Lake off and running. Steffen's pass inside to Ivy Haynes. Picture perfect. Give her the assist and the finisher there for Ivy Haynes.
Good job by Kropa to go to the sideline. That opened up the lane for Haynes just to sneak down there, get inside position, and get the layup as we've got a timeout called by the Raiders as the Wildcats have extended the lead to 9 points.
Haynes with 8 points already on the day. And this is kind of make or break time for Lyman. They need to get some sort of offense going here.
Don't forget that we'll present highlights from the state gymnastics competition coming up on Saturday at 3:30 Central, 2:30 Mountain Time on SDPB1. That will be after the fifth place game from the girls' AA basketball tournament. Again, just expect that to start about 3:30 Central, 2:30 Mountain Time Saturday on SDPB1 television.
9-point game right now. Kimball White Lake with the lead, but it'll be Lyman ball in the back. With 5:45 left to go in the third quarter. Allman with the ball in the left wing. She'll get it to the free throw line to Halverson. Now around to the right side. Flintner into the right corner. Intended for Brooklyn. Halverson, she recovers just before it goes out of bounds. Flintner finds Garnes at the top of the key.
2-3 zone for the Wildcats again.
Back to Flintner, right side of the paint. She spins away, picks up her dribble, now caught in no man's land. Passes it to the left post instead. Halverson with a nice turnaround put back. Brooklyn Halverson was 6 of 15 from the field yesterday with 14 points. She now has 6 points on the day here for Lyman.
Garnes just picked up her third foul. And looks like the Raiders going to put on the press.
5:10 left to go. Kimball White Lake with the ball and the lead.
Kimball White Lake, a team with a lot of players that are very versatile. They don't rely on just one player to bring the ball up the court.
4:57 left to go. Hinker at the free throw line, kicks it back outside. That's Nat Big. Haven't said her name a whole lot yet today. Hinker, right corner, picks up her dribble again. Gets it back in the top of the key to Nat Big. Into the left corner now. Kropa. Back to Hinker, inside in contact near the free throw line. No, they're going to say she traveled. 4:38 left to go on the scoreboard. 25-18 your score. We've got an immediate timeout coming up on the floor here in Huron. Right now, Kimball White Lake leading Lyman 25-16. More from the Class B Girls State Basketball Tournament after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Back in the Huron Civic Arena, 4:38 left to go in the third quarter. Kimball White Lake 25, Lyman 18. It'll be the Raiders with the ball. Lyman in the white uniforms with red lettering and black trim. Again, the Wildcats in their black uniforms with green lettering, blue and green trim down their uniforms. Garnes, dangerous pass into the left wing. Nearly went out of bounds, recovered by Flintner in the left wing though. Cross court pass back to Allman, right post. She got tangled up, and now a foul is going to be called on Kropa. Got in with the reach. For Kropa, that'll be her second. Second team foul as well for the Wildcats. Allman will inbound it. Garnas will set it up at the top of the key. Three from the right corner, in and out, no good. Garnas trying to run it down. It was last touched, though, by Stefan, out of bounds. Wildcats couldn't secure it, and neither could Lyman, but Lyman will keep the ball here with 4:09 left to go.
That was a good look from Allman from the corner, just couldn't get the shot to go.
Halverson with the ball at the free throw line, finds Garnas at the top of the key. She kicks it back into the left corner. Allman, guarded closely by Donald, now up to Flintner. Left side of the paint, picks up her dribble. Back to Allman. Garnas, right wing for three. That's off the front of the iron. Hits the glass and falls through. We talked about her shot, and that one, a shooter's touch. Finishes it off and gets Lyman back within four at 25-21.
The iron was kind to Chesney Garnas.
3:35 left to go. Pass inside. Turnaround right-handed. Layup is good for Ivy Haynes. Ivy now in double figures with 10 points on the day, joining Hinker in double figures on the floor. 2-3 zone for Kimball White Lake. Allman with the ball in the right wing. She fakes a pass inside, goes to Garnas at the top of the key. Picks up her dribble and now gets it back into the right wing.
There are both the Halversons trying to post up. It leaves Garnas open.
A little bit flat with the three that time, no good. Halverson fighting underneath for the rebound. But she's going to get called for the foul. Lyman's Haley Halverson called for the foul inside here. 3:06 left to go. 13 foul on Lyman here in this quarter. And it's her third personal of the day. Full court pressure coming from the Raiders, but Stefan breaks it easily. Into the front court. Ball's loose on the floor, but there's going to be a conversation here. It went off of multiple legs and ultimately went off of the Wildcats. 2:57 left to go. Garnas will bring it up. Not really a need for urgency at this point. Still a lot of time left in this third quarter, but down by six. You need to come away with some sort of points this time to try to cut away at this deficit. Right now, the two-possession game as the whistle's blown. Let's see who this one's on. Leon Stefan, her second for Kimball White Lake.
Check that. Third. Yeah, that's her third. And we'll have Brooklyn Donald check out. Wildcat, so Kelly Stefan's going to stay on with the three fouls.
Inbound coming from Allman underneath the Lyman hoop. Alverson picks up a dribble in the left wing. Down low to Flintner. Flintner fakes a shot, kicks it back outside.
Boy, this 2-3 zone has really caused Lyman some headaches.
Allman trying the three, in and out, no good. They're getting open looks from three, but their shots have been just a little flat here in the second half.
When they're passing the ball around the perimeter quickly, they're finding the open shooters, but they're just not getting the shots to fall. The problem is they're not consistently doing those quick passes. You've got to move the ball quickly around if you want to beat a zone.
Stefan wide open for three. That one's good. Big time shot for Stefan. That's a huge bucket for Kimball White Lake. It extends their lead now to 9 at 30-21 and a timeout called on the floor. Up here with 2:03 left to go in the third quarter.
Wildcats are going to call that particular timeout. Don't forget, coming up next week, our sports coverage continues here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We'll be at the state boys basketball tournaments. Class A will be on SDPB1. Class B will be on SDPB2. Class AA will be on SDPB3. And of course, coverage of all the high school championships available online at sdpb.org. That's March 20th through the 22nd, the state boys basketball tournaments. Update from the AA, Roosevelt in the second quarter, leading Rapid City Stevens 44-34. They've got a shootout going on there. It's the only update we have at the moment. From the other tournament, still waiting on word from the Pine Ridge-Garrison game.
Lyman taking the timeout there. They're left with just two timeouts on the day now. Kimball White Lake still with four. They're in good shape. But Lyman's going to have to be very careful on how they use these last two timeouts. And Cooper Garnas, hopefully, least was hoping in this situation that he can get his team settled down here. Down by nine, you can ill afford to miss another shot at this point. Need to come away with some sorts of points just to keep this single digits. The way Kimball White Lake has been shooting so far today. Alverson with the ball at the free throw line finds Chandler in the left wing. She thought about a dangerous cross-court pass, instead will bounce it to Garnis at the top of the key, and they'll reset the offense. Allman in the right wing now, with a minute 33 left to go. Looks inside, back to Garnis in the right corner. Again, they're looking inside, but this defense is really clamped down. Alverson, triple team, back outside. Garnis from the free throw line now, spins into traffic. Gets it back to Flintner. Minute 18 left to go in the third quarter. Garnis in the right wing, passes it back inside to Halverson. Left-handed hook shot, no good. Jandrew in the right place at the right time, though. Gets the left-handed layup to fall, and it's a seven-point game. Kimball White Lake with the lead, though. They get back into offensive mode.
Lyman's going to go man-to-man.
Pass inside. Ivy Haynes back out to Kropa in the right corner. Stephan spins it back into the corner, though. Haynes brings it out. Now, Gretchen. That's Ivy Haynes, and a foul called on Garnis. Tried to reach in. She knew it as soon as the foul was called.
And that's her fourth. I got an update on that eighth tournament. Pine Ridge defeats Gerritsen 44-35.
Garnis will take a seat on the bench for the remainder of this third quarter. 47 9/10 seconds remain. Kimball White Lake 30. Lyman 23. Jumper from Hinker, no good. Right baseline, rebounded underneath that time. Picking it up, Ashley Mortensen, who checked in. Played 8 minutes last night. Haven't said her name a whole lot here today, though. Jandrew tries to get it down low to Mortensen. It's tipped out of bounds off the fingertips of Ivy Haynes. 32 1/10 seconds remain as Donald checks in. Paige Munson checks out for the Wildcats. Inbound coming from underneath the hoop. It'll be Almond, who bounces it to Mortensen. Back to Almond, left corner for three. Nope, missed everything. Rebounded on the play by the Wildcats. It'll be Hinker to bring it into the front court. Looking for the final shot of the quarter here. Natvig gets it into the left wing.
We want to think Hinker would be the player to handle the basketball in the winning moments here of this third quarter for the Wildcats.
She gets it back into the hands of Kropa, right back to Hinker. She crosses over, lost her footing for a moment, now bounces it inside to Haynes. Her shot blocked, and that'll be how your first quarter comes to an end as Lyman content taking this one into the fourth quarter, down by seven, 30-23 your score. We'll have some more subs and much more coming from the Huron Arena after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Back in Huron as we get this fourth quarter underway. Lyman trails by seven, and they will be on defense to get this thing started. 30-23 your score. A couple players in double figures today for Kimball White Lake. Haynes has 10, Hinker has 10. Hinker with the ball now crossing the half-court line into the left wing. Kropa, 3 points on today, lobs it inside. Haynes with the putback, no, the foul.
She lost the handle on that little backdoor alley-oop play and draws the foul on Brooklyn Halverson. That'll be her third. A nice design play, and Hinker bobbled it to lemonade out of lemons there.
First free throw attempt, no good. What? Ivy Haynes going back to the free throw line again. Bucket, no good on the free throw attempt. 0-2 this time around. Score remains 30-23, a seven-point game. Lyman trying to get back into it with the ball in hand. Garnis in foul trouble in the game here right now. She's got four fouls. Dangerous pass tipped by the Wildcats, a near steal, but it goes out of bounds. It'll stay Raiders ball. 7:27 left to go. Lyman will inbound it.
That zone defense for the Wildcats, and Lyman at times has really struggled against that zone.
Ball in the left wing, Almond kicking it inside. Halverson back to the free throw line. No man's land. Almond now triple teamed again. Anytime they get the ball within 8 feet, seems like there's three black jerseys around the area. Not much Lyman could do there to try to draw the foul. Luckily, they get the ball this time. I'm going to call that on Kimball White Lakes. Paige Munson picks up her second personal. Inbound coming from Allman into the left wing. Garnes. Dangerous pass to Flintner in the right wing. Andrew back into the left wing now to Garnes. Allman inside finds Flintner at the free throw line. She couldn't pull the trigger though. Had the open look. Back to Flintner again. Now to Jandrew, right side of the paint. And a foul. They're going to say it's on the floor though. 15 foul on Kimball White Lake. Both teams now with five apiece. That'll be the third personal of the day on Mary Kropa. Allman will once again inbound it, this time right baseline, getting it to Jandrew in the right corner. Jandrew. Getting the ball inside to Flintner. She'll put it up off the glass, no good. Paige Munson with the rebound and a foul from behind. Down to the other end we go. Sixth team foul on the Lyman Raiders. And they're going to put that one on Jandrew this time.
Good box out again by Paige Munson. She averages 4 points, 4 rebounds per game, but her floor play, she just plays smart basketball.
Full court pressure coming from the Lyman Raiders. Trying for a turnover here and now, a little too much contact near the scorer's table. Jander riding the right hip the entire way as Hinker tried to make her way into the front court. Hinker. Getting into the bonus here, it should be a one-and-one situation, and it is. Seventh team foul called on Lyman.
Wildcats as a team, 61% from the free throw line on the year, so they got a chance to really extend this lead over the remainder of the contest at the free throw line.
Lyman's had their chances here in the fourth quarter. They've had a lot of looks, especially in that last offensive series. The free throw's made at the line right now, 8-point lead, 31-23. One. Hinker can make it a 9-point lead again for Kimball White Lake.
She's 3 of 3 on the day.
Free throw attempt is good. 6:37 left to go. 32-23, Kimball White Lake over Lyman. Again, earlier this season, the Lyman Raiders lost to Kimball White Lake 43-38. Kimball White Lake trying to get a second win against Lyman here today. Allman at the top of the key, finding Jander in the left wing. Cross-court pass, Garnes was waiting for it, but it's taken out of the air by Kropa. Into the front court, Stephan in the right wing. Wildcats are going to slow things down here now with 6:05 left to go in regulation. 32-23 your score, Wildcats in black. Dribbling around the perimeter. Not quite foul time yet for Lyman to try to stop the clock as Hinker gets the jumper to go from the left side of the free throw line and a timeout called by the Wildcats. They want to talk things over here now with an 11-point lead. That'll be the third timeout. Well, they will have 3 timeouts remaining, I should say. Lyman with 2 timeouts remaining and a full timeout called on the floor.
Second half score, Roosevelt leads Rapid City Stevens 49-41 at the AA tournament. Still waiting for the start of the second game at the A tournament. That will be Webster taking on Mount Vernon Plankington in consolation play. Spearfish has already won today. Pine Ridge has won today already, and so has Lemon here at the B tournament.
Yeah, again, the winner of this game will play Lemon in our consolation championship at 1:45. Whoever ends up on the losing end today will play Gabriel Vaughan tomorrow at noon. As we get to the afternoon brackets, pretty much all wrapped up here today, and still coming up tonight, we've got semifinal action starting at 6 p.m. Sully Buttes, who came in as the number one seed, will take on the defending champions and number 4 seed in this tournament, Warner. Hanson in our nightcap tonight will take on Sanborn Central Woonsocket. Both of those two games, the winner moves on to the championship tomorrow at 8 p.m. Central Time here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
And if you're coming to the game here in Huron, any of these semifinal games here tonight at the Civic Arena, get here early because I got a feeling it's going to be a packed arena.
Allman with the ball on the right wing. Lyman trying to get back in this game right now, down by 11. Garnes in the right corner. 5 points on the day, gets it to Jander at the top of the key. Back to Garnes. She'll try a three off the right side of the iron. No good. Ball picked up by Ivy Haynes. Into the front court we go. Wildcats with the ball. Take a look at Ivy Haynes' numbers on the day. 10 points, 5 rebounds, a perfect 4-for-4 from the field. They get it outside. Haynes with the ball in the right wing up to Stephan at the top of the key.
with this big lead, Kimball Whiteley can afford to be patient.
Kropa in the right corner, nearly lost the handle for a moment, recovers with Garnas all over. Garnas again with four fouls, has to be very careful. She picked up a reach in there a moment ago. She knew it. Steffen kicks it into the right corner. Kropa for three. It's good. That one rattled home. And Kropa hits the big tray. Extending the lead now 37-23. Largest lead of the day for the Wildcats. A 14-point lead. Ball in the right wing. Pass nearly stolen. Jandrew recovers. Kicks it to Halverson at the free throw line. Garnas, top of the key. The right corner, Allman. Lyman needs buckets here as Flintner tries a three, no good. Couple players had open looks there for Lyman, but there seemed to be some tentativeness. Nobody really wanted to pull the trigger. 4:10 left to go now in regulation. Kimball Whiteley with the lead, looking to add on to it.
And credit the Wildcats. Most of the day today, they have limited the Raiders to just one opportunity shooting the ball down the court. They've given them very few second chances.
Kimball Whiteley 11, make that 13 of 26 on the day now, shooting 50%. Lyman just 8 of 37. Allman gets the ball as that one went off the fingertips of Ivy Hinge. She couldn't quite handle the interior pass. Allman down the top of the key, lobs it inside. That one too strong over Flintner's head. And we reach our final media timeout of the day. 3:41 left to go in regulation. Kimball Whiteley 37, Lyman 23. Back with more Girls B Basketball on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Welcome back inside the Huron Arena. It will be Kimball Whiteley ball with 3:41 left to go. Hinker getting it with full court pressure coming from Jandrew and company. Lyman trying to get a stop here to get back in this game with 3:34 left to go. Hinker nearly lost it out of bounds. Jander got her hand on it, but it was last touched by the Raiders.
Raiders have yet to score in this fourth period.
37-23 your score. Kimball Whiteley still with the ball. Hinker in the left wing. They're going to try and waste as much time off this clock as they can now. Smelling victory. Still, Lyman has plenty of time to get back in this game if they can get their offense rolling, but it starts here and now. They've got to make a stop. As Steffen dribbles up to the free throw line, back to the top of the key to Kropa.
Raiders need to force a couple of turnovers, but one of their main players that forces steal, Garnas, has four fouls, but there's a mistake by the Wildcats.
Yeah,
now a pileup.
Steffen just dribbled the ball off her left foot. Allman was in the right place at the right time to secure it. A jump ball, but possession arrow favors the Lyman Raiders. So maybe a little longer than they would have liked, but they get the result they were hoping for. They get the ball without a bucket being made for Kimball Whiteley. Now 3 minutes left to go. Not necessarily time to start launching the threes, but making one wouldn't hurt. Lyman just one of 14 from long distance here today, shooting 7% from three-point land.
Raiders cannot have any empty possessions from here on out.
Garnas with a pass inside off the hands of Halverson. It'll go out of bounds. They're actually going to say last touched by the Wildcats. Kropa was in the area along with Ivy Haynes. One of those two got a fingertip on it. And now it'll be Allman to inbound it for Lyman. Garnas with the ball at the top of the key. Left-handed dribble. Dangerous lob pass into the left corner. Allman's pass was tipped by Steffen. It ends up in the hands of Hinker. She'll go coast to coast. Left-handed layup no good, though. Ball loose, recovered by Donald, but she was out of bounds on the baseline. So 2:26 left to go now, and Lyman with the ball again.
That was great defense by the Wildcats. Just couldn't cash in on the transition opportunity. But the Raiders very fortunate there that the Wildcats did not extend their lead even more.
2:15 left to go. Garnas finds Flintner in the right wing for Lyman. Jandrew in the right corner. Putting the ball to the floor, back to Garnas now with 2:05 left to go. Lyman's got to start getting a little urgency here as Flintner drives inside. That one halfway down, pops back out, rebounded by Donald. Wildcat ball with under 2 minutes now left to go. And Lyman remains scoreless here in the fourth quarter.
Great defense by the Wildcats. And Lyman, just tough luck. They've had some good looks like that last shot. It's just not falling, and we've got a foul.
Jandrew playing some good defense on Hinker, but that time a little too much contact with the hip. It'll send her to the free throw line. 8th team foul on Lyman. That's the third, by the way, on Jandrew. Hinker at the free throw line. Taking a look at her numbers today. Perfect 4 for 4 from the free throw line. She's also 5 of 9 from the field. Good for 14 points. As the free throw extends, her streak of consecutive free throws made to 5. And Cooper Garnas wants to talk things over using one of his last 2 timeouts here. He'll have 1 remaining. Kimball Whiteleg will have 3 in their back pocket with 1:42 left to go.
One of the all-time best concerts of classic blues, soul, and rhythm and blues was also one of the unlikeliest that happened during the 1989 presidential inauguration ceremonies for President George H.W. Bush, whose own taste ran more to Frank Sinatra and Randy Travis, but somehow it happened anyway, that with an all-star lineup that included the late Stevie Ray Vaughan, Albert Collins, Bo Diddley, Billy Preston, Sam Moore, Eddie Floyd, and a whole lot more. See a celebration of blues and soul tonight. Or check that'll be on Saturday night after the girls basketball on SDPB1 television.
1:42 left to go, 38-23 your score. Again, taking a quick look at the team numbers here today. Kimball Whiteleg shooting 50% as a team. They've got a 14-point lead, 13 of 26 today. They've only made half of their free throws today, 7 of 14, but even so, their offensive numbers have been good enough overall that they haven't needed to really make their free throws today. Lyman 6 of 8 from the free throw line, but find themselves down by double digits, largely because they're just 8 of 38 today. 30 misses in this game. They're shooting just 21% as a team. The free throw was good, by the way. Kimball Whiteleg now leading 39-23. So Garnas and company try to get at least a point here before the end of the fourth quarter. Jandrew in the left wing, trying to find a way to get through this Kimball Whiteleg defense. Shot no good from Halverson. Flintner with the rebound, and a foul on the play. That'll be on Hinker, I believe.
Yep, if so, that's her first. And just another good look here for Lyman. Just can't get the shot to fall.
Just about everything is contested, and there was a hand on that shot as she released it. Even so, she had enough to get it close to the hoop, and it just didn't quite fall her way. Garnas finds Allman in the right wing. 1:15 left to go. Ball dribbled off her foot, and the jump ball called with 2 members of the Wildcats getting a hand on it, and Allman getting her 2 on it. So I guess 2 players with 1 hand and then the other with 2 hands equals a jump ball here. Either way, it'll be Wildcat ball. 1:15 left to go. Ivy Haynes will bring it up. Actually now gets it off to Kroba. Full court pressure coming. Again, Garnas with her 4 fouls can't really do a whole lot here unless she wants to have her day come to an end a bit early. And there's the reach in from Flintner. That'll be her 3rd. 10th team foul on Lyman, crunching 19 foul.
Yeah, Lyman from the floor, 8 of 40 on the day, good for 20%. Kimball, 13 of 27, that's 48%, and that's your main storyline right there.
1 minute left to go in regulation as Stephen makes the free throw. Another attempt coming up here momentarily. Right-handed release on the way is good. 41-23, Kimball Whiteleg rolling away with this one in the final minute. They've all but punched their ticket now to the consolation championship against Lemon tomorrow at 1:45. All that remains in their way, the final 50 seconds of this game. Trying to put a shutout in the fourth quarter as Garnas dribbles right side baseline. Floater off the right side of the iron, no good. Jandrew's put back, no good. But a foul on the play and some free throws coming up for the Lyman Raiders.
It'll be Haynes picking up the foul. Credit Kimball Whiteleg, just great defense, sound fundamental basketball from the Wildcats today.
16 first half points for Lyman, just 7 here in the second half, and there takes away the goose egg on the scoreboard. Free throw made by Jandrew.
Gives her 6 points on the day.
Back at the free throw line, Jandrew with the spin of the ball and now the release. You get a look at our behind the backboard camera there. One of our many angles we'll be bringing you throughout the weekend here inside the Huron Arena. As this one gets into the final 30 seconds, stepping into the front court, Hinker with the ball. Run down this clock here. Flintner with a near foul. And there is the foul. Jandrew tried to get a steal. I think we're dribbling near our spot here at the scorer's table. 21 seconds remain, and there will be 2 free throws coming up with Lyman committing their 10th foul. So two free ones here for Hinker, who's got 16 points on the day. Two rebounds. She's a perfect 6-for-6 from the line, but misses this one. We'll have another coming up here momentarily. Go ahead.
Hinker playing a great game on both ends of the floor today.
Second attempt is good. 1 of 2 from the line. She'll miss just one from the stripe today, going 7 of 8 from the free throw line overall. She's got 17 points to lead all scorers in this one here today. Allman, top of the key, has her bounce pass tip recovered. Garnes trying a three from the right wing, and that one's good. Second three-point make for her today. Just the second make as a team for Lyman, though. Now 2 of 15 from three-point land. And that's how it wraps up. Kimball White Lake will move on to the Consolation Championship. They will face Lemon tomorrow at 1:45 after a 42-28 win over Lyman. We'll take a timeout. More stats, recaps, and more coming your way after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Back in Huron as we wrap up our first two games of the afternoon. We've officially reached the midway point of this tournament with our consolation bracket kind of taking shape here today. Before we get to that, though, Steve, let's take a look at the final numbers in this one with Kimball White Lake punching their ticket to the Consolation Championship after a 42-28 win.
Well, the Kimball White Lake Wildcats had 20 points total as a team in the second half compared to Lyman, who only got 7 points in the third quarter and 5 points in that fourth quarter, and those 5 points coming in the last minute of play. The defense for the Wildcats just great, as Lyman just had cold shooting on the day. The Raiders were 9 of 42 from the floor for 21%. The Wildcats were 13 of 27 from the floor, a very efficient 48%. From beyond the three-point arc, Wildcats were 4 of 11 for 36%, and 2 of 15 on the game, rather, for Lyman. That's just good for 13%. They were 2 of 9 in the second half of play. From the free throw line, Kimball White Lake, I should say, 12 of 20 for 60%, and 8 of 10 for the Raiders in the game. Individual scoring, Jasmine Hinker, another sensational game, 17 points. 10 for Ivy Haynes, 8 for Kelly Steffen, 6 for Mary Kropa, and 1.5 rebounds on the day for Paige Munson. Meanwhile, for Lyman, they were led by Chesney Garnos with 8.7 for Cedar Jandrew off the bench, 6 for Brooklyn Halverson, 4 for Bailey Allman, and 3 for Haley Halverson on the bench. The rebounding battle pretty even, 26-23 in favor of the Wildcats. Turnovers even at 12 apiece, but just some great defense. I'll tell you what, that 2-3 zone really caused some problems for Lyman, especially in the second half.
We will take another quick timeout. When we come back, we'll update you on games from across the rest of the tournament. We'll take a look at our evening session coming up with our semifinals underway, and we will take a look at some other games going on across the state. All that and more coming up after the break right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
Back in Huron as we wrap up our first two games on our second day overall of this tournament here in Huron, South Dakota. J.J. Hardigan, Steve Toom with you as you see the final score there. Kimball White Lake, the victors today, and will play in the Consolation Championship tomorrow after defeating the Lyman Raiders. Steve, let's take a look at the bracket and update everybody on where teams stand here heading into our evening session.
Yep, tonight the semifinals will start at 6 Central, 5 Mountain Time tonight here on SDPB3 television. Our first matchup, the defending champions, the Lady Monarchs of Warner, will be taking on the number one seed, Sully Buttes. That ought to be a dandy, and we'll follow that up with what should be a good game as well. Hanson, third place last year, taking on Sanborn Central Woonsocket. Again, we'll start at 6 Central, 5 Mountain Time tonight. The consolation action will begin at noon tomorrow, noon Central Time. We'll have Gayville Vollen taking on Lyman, and that'll be followed by Lemon versus Kimball White Lake. That will be for the consolation championship. Around the state, earlier today at the AA tournament, it was Spearfish beating Harrisburg 48-45. And the last update we had was Sioux Falls Roosevelt was leading Rapid City Stevens. Don't have a final scoring on that yet. At the A tournament out west, Pine Ridge posted a 44-35 victory over Garrison earlier today. And just getting underway is Winter versus Mount Vernon Plankington. That is on SDPB2 television. So if you want to watch some more girls basketball action, that check out SDPB1. I think they're still going there. SDPB2, they are, of course, getting the later start. So they will have plenty of action throughout the day as well. Don't forget, you can keep up to date with everything at sdpb.org. We're going to take a break here for a few hours, give our crew and you a chance to catch our breath, and we'll come back for the evening session. Again, we start at 6 Central, 5 Mountain Time tonight, semifinals. This is the Class B State Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.